Let me tear the Band-Aid off here. I'm leaving the show. I will be leaving Tim and Sid. We're going to do 5 more weeks of this. And our last show together, our last show will be, Friday, February the 26th. That will be the last Tim and Sid. But we're going to do another 5 weeks. And I'm going to attempt to do with Tim what I've done for 17 years-ish, talk sports and try and make him giggle. That will be the mandate for the next 5 weeks. I didn't get fired, to the disappointment of some. I'm cutting that at the knees right now. So if a blogger with 1,000 followers wants to start that garbage, you can stop. I'll tell you what's up in a second. Tim McAuliffe will take the mic in a second, because obviously the questions that branch off here are numerous. And for a lot of you who've been with us for a very, very long time, that turned a little podcast into what I consider one of the best TV shows and radio shows this country's ever seen, in my humble opinion, I think you are owed a couple of explanations here. So give me a few minutes here, Timmy, and then I'll back off.
Of course.
Because you need some space here too, because there's a lot to talk about here.
This is your news, you know, show.
It's our news as well. I appreciate that. It's our news as well. Just so you know, programming wise, again, Norman Powell's coming up, Brian Burke's coming up. They're coming up in hour 2. This hour is us. Mm-hmm. So,
and you,
and me. So, and them, and all of us,
all of us,
all of us. Thank you. So this, growing up, my dream was to work in sports. And I got to accomplish that, and it was damn cool. I didn't want to do anything else. I don't think Tim wanted to do anything else, because we just love sports that much. Confirm, Tim agreeing, he didn't want to do anything else. And I got lucky. I was on air at the age of 20. And like Wonder Kid, you know, Phenom, whatever. Titles aren't important.
Yeah. Sorry. Yes. Go on. Continue.
That's what I want. Tim, you're helping me. That's what I want. This is good. This is good. I like it. So I've been doing sports a long time and doing it with Tim, and we've got to do some wild stuff, man. And it's kind of culminated into a simulcast, not only on national TV, but in a chair, essentially, of one of my broadcasting heroes growing up, in Bob, like, to be in this time slot. So I've been very, very, very lucky. And the thing is, as I've gotten a bit older, and Tim can speak to this more than anybody, based on conversations on and off air, down through the years, not just recently, but down through the years, a lot of other things have kind of started to interest me. And sports is a love of mine. It's always going to be a love of mine. But I felt like maybe there was another challenge out there. And the one of the things the pandemic did teach me is, and I apologize to those internally who I've said this to a couple of times. I don't want to sound repetitive, but is to no longer hesitate, because life doesn't care about your plans, man. Like, it just doesn't at all. So, an opportunity came up, and I didn't hesitate, because it was unique, it was different, and only something like that would pull me away from literally being allowed with Tim to say whatever the hell I want on air. Literally, within reason. That's the gig. That's the freedom we've been allowed from a 20-year-old kid on air, a guy named Anthony Ciccioni put him on air, to now. That's the freedom. So you're not going to leave for anything. And that's and certainly one of those unique opportunities has arisen. So here's what I'm going to do. Our last show was February 26th. On March 10th, I will become the co-host of Breakfast Television alongside Dina Pugliese on City TV. I don't want to think about the hours now. It's not important. But I will be joining the Breakfast Television team.
All right. Go back.
Damn, that was loud.
Continue.
Damn, that, I'm sorry.
That was loud.
I was in the middle of the thing.
Wanted to give you something to keep. I appreciate it.
I mean, Tim and I have been watching this show. For those of you who aren't in the Southern Ontario area, and I know a lot of you are getting familiar with Dina and everyone at BT nationally. That show is pretty important to the fabric of the city of Toronto. It's very important to the fabric of the GTA, the Greater Toronto Area, and it's a part of people's lives, and it will afford me, if I might be selfish about this, it will afford me the opportunity to just kind of do some stuff I can't do right now that interests me. And again, I go back to conversations. Tim knows better than anybody what kind of a news junkie I am. Sometimes to my detriment. Sometimes to my detriment. Yeah. But it's going to be a hell of a challenge. But anyone who's watched Tim and I also know we have this kind of unique history with BT, and that Dina Pugliese, Tim, and myself, I believe, will eternally hold the Canadian record for consecutive commercialless hours of television. That record will never be broken at the Raptors Parade, and I hold that record dear to my heart.
And
so
and eternal love for each other.
Yes.
And eternal love for each other. Just let me know if you want to break in here, Sid, and get into a word in edgewise.
I'm almost done. I'm almost done.
Go ahead.
Just 20 more minutes. So, like I said, this is a I'm on two mindsets right now. I'm really excited about going to Breakfast Television, and I'm coming in hot, and I'm ready, and I am I only know how to be me. And I've been proving people wrong for 20 years. I see no reason to stop now. So I'm excited. Timmy,
No. Let's go. Keep going here.
Promise mess, I wouldn't do this. I love you, brother.
I know.
Please take it.
I know. I know you do.
Please take it.
I know you. And anyone who watches the show or follows us on social media knows that for us, the last 10 or so months have come with, like many of you, a lot of reflection. So as Sid makes this announcement and I smile and I chuckle and I laugh, I get it. And I sat back because this is Sid's news. I'm not going to go anywhere. If you want to get rid of me, I'm sorry. I'm not going anywhere. But I've known for years, and I think a lot of the Timmins citizens who have been with us for a while recognized your want and need to spread your wings and fly. And I'm happy that after all these years, you will get a chance to spread your wings and fly and do it in a place where both you and I know it'll be bleeping awesome. So it's bittersweet because I lose the guy that I laughed with all the time. Woo! That I laughed.
We need a third. We need a third jumping on here, man. Where's Blair?
Can we get the third person?
Where's Deitch? We need someone to jump in, fill some time, play some music.
So I'll miss laughing a lot. But such is life. And,
such is life, man. You're right.
I understand and I get it.
I appreciate that. I appreciate that. And listen, all I hear is his phone and my phone, by the way, right now. That's all I hear is McAuliffe's phone and my phone right now.
And let me warn people. I'm an emotional mess as a person. Like, I am just
better.
I don't care
right
what
now.
It is. I cried during Rudy. I'm fine with it. I'll probably cry in this situation, even though Sid and I don't really like each other all that much. You know, the start of this thing was so free flow and we could do anything. It was a podcast. And for those of there have been several iterations of this. And for those who have been with us for every one of the iterations, I love you guys. Sid loves you guys. And you gave us all that we could ask for and more. But, you know, we did all these things like race, politics, ice dancing, taking the Browns to the Super Bowl. And nobody said nothing. They just enjoyed the ride along with us. And nobody screamed stick to sports or any of that nonsense or worse. So stick to news doesn't work, Sydney. So go ahead. Go to news. Go to an institution in our city and stick of our lives. And you're stick to news, a-hole.
We'll enjoy. Don't come in this leaf lane. They're going to miss Thornton big time. Who the hell are you?
Right. Right. So there's natural questions, and we'll get to them. We have an hour.
I want to say two things. One, to what you just said about the questions, Tim, because Sarah Grossman, a Sportsnet PR, who's amazing, I was talking to her this week, and she asked about, do you want to do some interviews? I'm like, I understand the question, but I do have a national TV show and a drive time show with McAuliffe. Let's just talk here. Like I want to, now me being egotistical thinking all the requests are coming in, probably not, but as I said to Tim earlier today, I think, there are probably a lot of questions at Tim and Sid right now, and I understand them. Timmy, you can ask me anything you want. I don't know if I'm comfortable answering them. I'll plead the fifth on a couple, but, if you want to go down that road, because I think people deserve to kind of hear some stuff, and I'm cool with it.
First episode of Tim and Sid, the podcast. I don't know if you remember this, but we started and we said, this show is yours. Whatever you want us to do, you tell us, and we'll do it. And we've done it since. So if you want questions, we'll give you the answers. And if you have any questions about what remains and what will happen after Sid, we'll try and answer those as best we can. And if you want to ask Sid why, how, when, go ahead. My first one comes to us from Jean-Pierre Gagné. And Jean-Pierre Gagné asks, does Sid know that breakfast television doesn't start at 10 a.m.?
I thought breakfast was a euphemism for something else. It's that early? I haven't even gone through the schedule yet.
It's earlier than that.
I got to call Roshni. I don't know when I'm getting up. She's going to be so angry with me.
She's going to be so pissed. Zachary writes in, there's a lot of no, Sid Seixeiro, I need you, with a lot of exclamation points from Zachary Taylor.
Yeah, where were you in high school? Didn't hear that.
Okay. Jamie says, congratulations, Sid Seixeiro.
I was waiting for something.
I already miss you. I wish you the best. Loving watching every day. Good on you for grabbing an opportunity. Tim McAuliffe, I'm available to be your new co-host. I think I'll get a few of those.
Well, hold on, Tim. In all seriousness, before you go to the next one, as someone who sat in this national television drive time chair with Tim, it's a good gig. Now, you don't need me to say that. You don't need Tim to say that. But, Tim, I have a sneaking suspicion. There's going to be some people reaching out, because this is as focused as you and I are mostly when we come in. There's worse gigs than this. So I agree with that. The ether.
I'll say this though. And all the co-hosts who have ever come on with us, I hope people understand how much goes into this show every day. Like we don't fake off a sport and say, we don't like soccer, or we're not going to talk football because it's violent, or we're not going to tackle this issue because it might get us a stick to sports tweet or two. Like, we hit everything head on. And because of it, you can't half-ass this show or you will be found out. And that's one of the real challenges of replacing the guy that sits usually across from me and in his basement beside me, is that this ain't easy. And people make it look easy, but it's not easy. So replacing you will be very, very, very hard.
On looks alone, Tim.
I don't even.
On looks alone, I'm amazing. Like, where are you? You on a good day, Donovan? Yeah. But like, not Faisal. Not
dress
like
is better. Better hair. Yeah,
well, what are you trying to make up for there?
Both of them.
Uh-huh. I'm just saying. I think I'm way better looking than I ever got credit for. I think this is the real issue I want to get to in this show, is how I didn't get enough credit for being a handsome.
For being a handsome
that's
man?
That's my beef. That's my beef.
That's your biggest beef.
On this day. That's the headline today. You're going to want to hear this.
Do you want to hear the Paul Langill, "We will miss you, Sid Seixeiro, wow, this hurts"? The Spencer, "No way Tim and Sid can end" with crying emojis. Like, do you want to hear that stuff? Brian said, "You just made me guzzle my third beer, you jerk."
You were going to do that anyway, bud. You know that. Don't put that on me. Don't put that on me. You were going to do that anyway. Too. Don't put that on me.
A guy named Jacques Strapp writes in, not kidding, "I'm shooketh. Been loyal fan since the Score days. I'm going to miss Sid. And I know he knows you because he included a cat emoji."
Oh, I haven't told my cat yet.
Oh, doctor.
I think she's going to take it horribly. All I hear is McAuliffe's phone. This is.
Should I move that to my lap?
No. Just put it like on silent. Like, it's on vibrate now. I hear it every single time. I don't know if people at home are hearing what I'm hearing, but I'm hearing the phone every time. Go.
They're just resumes, Sid, of people waiting to replace you as quickly as they possibly can.
Wait till the body's cold first. My God, guys. Text him after.
Is there anything else that you would like to say? Because, Sid Seixeiro, you've waited for me to say this on this show for probably 15 years. Sid, this is your day.
No, time to get really honest here. This has been going on behind the scenes for a while, as you might expect. I'm just really proud to stay at a secret, if I'm being perfectly honest with you. Like, I'm proud of a lot of things. I'm proud of this show, what we created, where we're at. How many people who hate us and keep listening every day? You're my favorites. Thank you very much. But like, the fact that this didn't get out, if anyone in Rogers has any question of whether or not you could trust me going forward, don't worry about it, because we're good. We're good. And I'm really proud. I just, honestly, it meant a lot for me to, and for people at home who wouldn't know, there've been some team discussions earlier today. So we did obviously talk, but publicly, it just didn't come out. And I'm really proud, and I know who I can trust, is basically what I'm also saying. And I'm proud that the Tim and I could announce this here, because especially after the last year, because it would have been disappointing if it would have leaked somewhere else, because that's what I think of the show. So
we're going to get to commercial break, and then we're going to come back with some of the tweets and some of the memories, because I think that's in order. And then Norm Powell and Brian Burke are going to join us, because that's just what we do.
Will we get Brian back to the Burke sports. Wish us well, or just tear us a new one?
Tear us. Will he do? I hope he does. I'm really proud of what we were able to accomplish. And moreover, the community that we created online, on radio, and TV. It might be the thing that I'm most proud of, the Tim and Citizens. Like, how many shows have accomplished anything close to moving the needle on TV, radio, and online? Like, screw it. Podcast, too, because we started there. That's four different platforms where the Tim and Citizens and the people who absorb this show and just like laughing about their sports and actually knowing their sports move the needle for us. Working with someone who not only understood that, but fostered it, is among the best things that I have done in my career, without a doubt. And I think I'm seeing folks starting to reminisce on Twitter and the gram.
For sure.
And if I have a specific moment, I'll do that too coming up. But I just need to say, never mind the last 10, 15, 5 years, whatever you've been absorbing this show in, specifically the last 10 months and what this team went through physically and emotionally to bring you a distraction or an important conversation, absolutely no BS here. I am remarkably proud of that guy. Sid Seixeiro, I'm remarkably proud of our entire team who did not stop at any time to be able to shelve our emotions and fears and tell you the dad joke of the day or the good news of the day, or not to shelve our emotions and fears in the last 10 months and wear it on our sleeves. I couldn't be prouder of the guy that I sit across, that I could trust to do that with, and the people behind the scenes. Because
well said.
It's something to be proud of.